Good evening, it's Kuro. Got a random game in my tier 8 Oland, going over the matchmaking, looking at a Saipan, Tirpitz, Colorado, Sinop, West Virginia, Mutsu, Otago, Chapiev. I don't even know how to begin to pronounce this one. Perth, Akazuki, and Nevni. The map's Land of Fire, standard battle, and gonna kick this one off with a ship that had been requested from a viewer. And, yeah, haven't played Oland in a bit. It's not a bad boat, and just gonna kick this thing off. Honestly, terrible spawn. I don't like the configuration that I've got, where I've got a German battleship, a German light cruiser. All of those things usually scream trouble to me, in particularly the Nuremberg. This is a terrible map for a Nuremberg. Well, spawn wise, he can do all right over on the eastern side of the map, but this is just too open out here. He's gonna get overmatched and dumpstered really quickly. So what I'm doing up here, I'm taking, there's no cap up here, so what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to take a path where my concealment circle isn't really likely to bump into an enemy DD. What I'm trying to do is get some early spotting on. Is there a cruiser or battleship pushing in anywhere? And then try to get torps off on them and maybe get some early torp damage. So here we go. Nice thing about Oland is even though it's tier 8, you do have 12 kilometer torps. Now I'm kind of being cautious, that's why I'm slowing down to make this turn. I want to give my guns time to turn. The guns aren't nearly as fast as Holland and the higher tier pan-European destroyers. Now this is dangerous. I do spot the Chappie of them. I was being a little greedy there. Akazuki pops up now for whatever reason, I don't know what, but this Chappie, he's just like target fixated on this Heinrich, and he doesn't shoot. I just stay dark, throw some torpedoes out on this Akazuki, and then just disappear. And I can already tell my Nuremberg is going to be disappearing here very shortly. He is, all of his support is headed north, and he is headed south in probably the squishiest ship in the battle. And you can see shots coming in from the West Virginia. I do pick up a torpedo on the Akazuki, and that's going to mean that's a fight that I can probably take. So notice, as I'm positioning, I'm not moving to get in front of where these guys are pushing. I'm trying to stay on their broadside. This Mutsu, he's probably gonna cut like this through the island. So I'm trying to line up torpedoes on this guy. Unfortunately, I should have held my torps a little bit longer, let this guy stabilize his course. Little trick here, if you notice, I took that shot, didn't get detected. I actually shot outside my gun range and let the ship sail within my gun range, and dropped a couple shots on him. Maybe you get a fire out of that deal, or maybe not, you don't know. Engine boost deactivated. Pick up the Akazuki again. Now this is going to be a rough fight because this Chapayev is going to jump right up, and I don't really have a lot of support out here. You can see that Chapayev pops up under 11 kilometers. It's, I was a little surprised he was that close, but I'm just going to try to secure this Akazuki, and not doing a very good job of it. And that's gonna cost me some HP. He goes down, just gonna keep kiting. Fortunately, the Chapayev is target fixated on this Ganiza now, and I am just gonna move out. Once I see nobody shooting at me, I'm gonna go ahead and repair the fire, and just keep moving. So I know that the western flank is done. Our Ganiza now is not gonna be able to hold against all of that. I would be doubtful if a super unicum battleship player in a Ganiza now could tank those three ships. So I'm moving already to where I can be productive, and that is sealing off the middle and getting torpedo angles on the eventual push to the middle of the map in towards our cap, and go from there. Just waiting right here for this island to be out of the way. It looks like the Mutsu's turning in. Now really what I should do here is spin back around in reverse, because the path that I'm sailing is giving me worse and worse torpedo angles. So if I circle back around, I get a better torpedo angle the more I sail this way. I'm still pushing this way mainly out of the interest that I'm expecting more traffic coming up in the middle, and I want to kind of make sure that my team doesn't get flanked by ships that push right up through here. Our CV is already down. That does not bode well for our prospects this battle. So right here, I'm looking, see if I can pick up the Sinop, see what that Mutsu's doing. That Mutsu's been kind of an erratic driver, so I'm going to just switch targets and take a poke at this Sinop. That's something if you're just running into a stubborn target for your torpedoes. Just go to another target. That person may be running like a crazy anti-torpedo build or something like that. If you get two, maybe three really good chances on that ship, and it doesn't really work out, just move on to a target where you're going to be more productive. Pan-European torpedoes doing what they do. My teammates doing what they do this game, and yeah, I don't even know. Fortunately, they're able to trade, but that's kind of painful when you're talking about coming around the corner when you've got torps rolling in that are gonna, take 85% of the HP off that battleship. So again, just trying to predict. I want to be on the broadside of where these ships are traveling, and at the same time have them pushing into me, so the torpedoes have the least amount of reaction time. And I'm thinking that this Tirpitz is just going to try to rush this Normandy. So I'm sitting here waiting for that turn in, and it's not going to happen. It's actually a Tirpitz that's going to turn out. So just take a lead. Tirpitz is a pretty fast battleship, so take a decent lead on those torpedoes, send them out, and it's time to reposition. Always use that torpedo reload as an opportunity to reposition. I'm gonna get in here closer to this Normandy. I'm predicting he's gonna be needing some AA support here shortly. Time to go dark with that Perth shooting. Engine boost activated. He's a little too close for comfort. Unfortunately, not doing too much to these Saipan planes. They're pretty tough. And unfortunately, down goes my Normandy. I know that this game's going to be a loss. If you look, my team's slowly getting boxed out, and there's not much they can do. This West Virginia is going to keep pushing in here. So the only thing I can really keep doing is look at targets that are pushing and try to put torpedoes on them. Got this Mutsu here. What I'm thinking about doing is pushing down here, getting good torpedoes off, and then on the next torpedo reload, kind of pushing back across if I've got the room to get a nasty set of torps off on this West Virginia. And these dive bombers, they're gonna ruin my plans. So I'm just going to try to turn around, get plane safe. And at this point, I'm just going to start making my last stand, try to get as much damage as I can, and I'm just going to start gunboating. Now the unfortunate part is I am in a crossfire between the West Virginia and the Mutsu. That's going to make it so much easier for the enemy team to always get a good shot on me. Got a fire. Shells coming in from the West Virginia. I think I drive right into him. Big hit there. And just gonna take these last few seconds, try to get my torpedoes out. That's the end of me. Unfortunately, no follow-up fires, and it doesn't look like these torpedoes are gonna hit with a battleship turning out. No torpedo hits. And this game's going to go down here very shortly as a loss. That's just unfortunate. Oland, though, however, solid ship. Was able to tank 1.4 million over the course of the battle. You can do a lot better than that if you're not stuck in a crossfire and you're just, you know, kiting with your engine boost on. There at the end, I was, you know, aside from it being a last stand, that's playing too aggressive with your guns. You know, these sorts of games, they happen these days. It's, you just kind of wonder what your team's doing when, you know, you're on a light flank and your heavy flank, your team just gets rolled. Doesn't make no sense sometimes, but it is what it is. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the game. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. Hope you're having a good night, and I will talk to you later.